زادك الأيام فتى.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Inshallah ta'ala, today I will be inshallah ta'ala going over the history and the origins of Shi'ism, the history and the origins of it. So inshallah ta'ala, this silsila, these episodes, these series, inshallah ta'ala, is what do you know about Shi'ism? Amma, what do you know of Shi'ism? So inshallah ta'ala, the way I plan to go through it is as follows. Inshallah ta'ala, in this sit, I will go through a bit about who Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu was. And then inshallah ta'ala, I will speak through Ali ibn Abi Talib and his khilafah, and Mu'awiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his khilafah, and Yazid ibn Mu'awiyah and his khilafah. And I will mention inshallah ta'ala a lot of history and realities that took place inshallah ta'ala. I will also speak about every sect and every group that came out from the Shia groups within those period of times inshallah ta'ala, where they originate from. And inshallah ta'ala, as this series is going to go on for a while, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem, I will give it its justice according to my ability. And inshallah ta'ala, I will quote a lot of times reference points of their own works and their own books, things in which they have admitted and agreed to, in order for a person of the sunnah to see the reality of Shi'ism. And walil asaf al-shadeed, with a lot of sadness and sorrow, we nowadays see people who think good of the Shia and who don't understand the reality of what the Shia are and their belief. And so it's falling into praising them, justifying their actions, and giving them excuses. When in reality, if you knew who the Shia are, and the reality that took place between us, the Sunni and the Shia, you would see a lot of amazement, and your mind would be open to know what type of people they are. Without any further ado, inshallah ta'ala, I will start. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his name is Ali ibn Abi Talib ibn Abd al-Muttalib ibn Hashim ibn Abd Manaf, and he's the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam's first cousin. He's the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his cousin ibn Ammi al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Wazawwaja, and the prophet wazawwaja, who Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the prophet married him off to his own daughter Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, sayyidati nisa'il alamin. The prophet married her off to him, Ali ibn Abi Talib. And Ali ibn Abi Talib is who? Wa Abu Sibtain. He is the father of the two righteous individuals, Hassan and Hussain, the grandchildren of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His mother's name was Fatima bint Asad ibn Hisham ibn Abd Manaf. That is the name of who? The mother of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Fatima bint Asad ibn Hisham ibn Abd Manaf. His kunya, Ali ibn Abi Talib, was Abu al-Hasan. And the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَكَنَّاهُ النَّبِيُّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam بِأَبِي تُرَاب. The messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him this kunya, Abu Turab, the father of the sand, the dust. And it has its story and why the Prophet called him this. Aslama saghiran. Ali ibn Abi Talib took Islam very young. He took Islam, according to the strongest view, as Ibn Abdul Barr mentions in his Kitab al-Isti'ab, he took Islam when he was 8 years of age. Ibn Thamaniya Sinin. He was 8 when he took Islam. Ibn Abdul Barr described how Ali ibn Abi Talib looked like. He said, وَأَحْسَنُ مَا رَأَيْتُ فِي صِفَةِ عَلِيٍّ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ أَنَّهُ كَانَ رَبْعَةً مِنَ الرِّجَالِ إِلَى الْقِصَرِ مَا هُوَ. Ali ibn Abi Talib, the best description I heard regarding him, Ibn Abdul Barr says, that he was a man the same height of an ordinary individual. But he was more closer, if you had to choose between height and shortness, he was more closer to be short. أدعج العينين حسن الوجه كأنه القمر ليلة البدر حسنا. His eyes, they were what? Deep in. He had a beautiful face. His face was as though it was like the moon, when a full moon. ضخم البطن, بطن. He had a very big stomach. عريض المنكبين. His shoulders were wide. أصلح ليس في رأسي شعر. His hair was bald, he had no hair. إلا من خلفي, except at the back. كبير اللحية. His beard was very big. علي بن أبي طالب. Ali ibn Abi Talib, his wives are as follows. 8 women he married. The first of them was Fatima, bintu Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He also married Umama bint Abi al-As. Khawla bint Ja'far ibn Qais, Layla bint Mas'ud, Ummul Banin bint Hizam, Asma bint Umays. صحباء بنت ربيعة أم سعيد بنت عروة. علي بن أبي طالب married all those women. أمامة بنت أبي العاص, the second woman he married, her mother was who? Her mother was Zainab, the daughter of the Prophet. أمامة بنت أبي العاص, her mother was Zainab, the daughter of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He married her after Aisha died, Fatima died. He married her after Fatima died. Now, he had a lot of children. His children was Hassan and Hussain and Muhammad, the older one. He had more than one Muhammad. Muhammad al-Akbar, Ubaidullah, Abi Bakr, al-Abbas al-Akbar. He had Uthman, Ja'far, the older Ja'far. He also had Abdullah, Yahya, Aun, Umar, older Umar, younger Umar. He also had 3 Muhammads. When one was Muhammad al-Akbar, he had Muhammad al-Awsat and Muhammad al-Asghar. His daughters, Zainab, Ummu Kalthum, Ruqayya, Ummu al-Hasani, Ramlat, Ummu Hani, Maymuna, Fatima, Khadija, Ummu Salama, Ummu Ja'farin, Jumanatu. These were the names of his daughters. Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Ali's virtues are excessive. And the scholars, when they categorize his virtues, they categorize it into 3. Virtues that were specific to him, virtues that he shared with the Prophet's family, and the third one was virtues which he shared with the companions with. So Ali shared virtues with the companions, as he was a companion. He shared virtue being part of the Prophet's family. He had a virtue in that. So any narrations that come regarding the virtue of the companions, Ali has a portion in that. Any virtues that come regarding Ahlul Bayt Rasulillah, the Prophet's family, Ali has a portion in that. Because he's from the Prophet's family, and as we're all aware of, the Prophet's family, they have virtue. The third one is the virtues that were specific to him. He only had it himself. The evidence, the ones that are specific to him are what we're going to speak about here. The ones that were specific to him is like the hadith of Abi Huraira, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Bukhari and Muslim narrated. The day of Khaybar, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَأُعْطِيَنَّ الرَّايَةَ, I'm going to give the banner. رَجُلًا أَيْمَان يُحِبُّ اللَّهَ, he loves Allah. وَرَسُولُهُ and his messenger, وَيُحِبُّهُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, he loves Allah and his messenger, and Allah and his messenger love him. That's the person I'm going to give the banner to. And the messenger gave it to who? He gave it to Ali ibn Abi Talib. The Prophet called for Ali. Ali was sick that day. He had a problem with his eye. The Prophet called him, where's Ali? He said, he's not here. The Prophet asked for him to be brought, and Ali was brought, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spat in his eye for him, and read on him, and Ali's eye got better, and the Prophet gave him the banner. From his virtues are that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to him, لا يحبك إلا مؤمن. No one loves you except he's a believer. ولا يبغضك إلا منافق. And no one hates you except he's a hypocrite. The Messenger said this about him. The hadith is collected by Imam Muslim. Bukhari and Muslim also narrated another hadith regarding the virtue of Ali that was specific to him. That the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, Ali, when he looked at him, he said, أَنْتَ مِنِّي بِمَنْزِلَةِ هَارُونَ مِنْ مُوسَى. You are to me the position that Harun was to Musa. إِلَّا أَنَّهُ لَا نَبِيَّ بَعْدِي. Except there is no prophet after me. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying to Ali, you are to me like Musa was to Harun, except there is no prophet after me. So this hadith, what does it show? The virtue of Ali specifically, and there are other benefits or virtues regarding him. So this shows us what, brothers and sisters and listeners? It shows us that Ahlul Sunnah, our Aqeedah, is to love the Sahabas, one. And it's to love the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, two. And it's to specifically like Ali ibn Abi Talib. Because the Messenger said in the hadith, لا يحبك إلا مؤمن ولا يبغضك إلا منافق. So Ahlul Sunnah, in our Dawaween Sunnah, the books of the Sunnah, what do you realize? That we are the ones who love the Prophet's companions. And we are the ones who love the Prophet's family. And we are the ones who love Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ali ibn Abi Talib, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whilst he was alive, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose Ali to be a judge. Because of that which the Prophet saw in him, and that which he knew of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Al-Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, bi isnadin sahih, an authentic chain of narration. Ali said about, he said this about himself, he said, ba'athani Rasulullah, the Messenger sent me, ila al-Yamani, to Yemen. The Prophet sent me to what? He sent me to Yemen. Faqultu, I said to the Prophet, ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, إِنَّكَ تَبْعَثُنِي, O Messenger of Allah, you're sending me, إِلَىٰ قَوْمٍ, to a people, هُمْ أَسَنُّ مِنِّي, they are older than me in age. You're sending me to a people who are older than me in age. لِأَقْضِيَ بَيْنَهُمْ, so I can judge between them. The Messenger said to him, اِذْهَبْ, go. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى, go. For verily Allah, سَيُثَبِّتُ لِسَانَكَ, Allah is going to make your tongue firm on the haqq. وَيَهْدِيَ قَلْبَكَ, and Allah is going to guide your heart, Ali. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, whilst the Prophet was alive, he earned that status in being a judge, the Messenger electing him and sending him to the people of Yemen in order to what? To judge between the people's affairs. People who were older than him in age. And that shows his smartness and the great value and characteristics that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu had. The next point that inshallah ta'ala we're going to focus on is Bay'atu Aliyin bil Khilafah. How Ali ibn Abi Talib was elected to be the Khalifa of the Muslimin. The story is as follows. Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya, whose name is Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib. His name is called Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya. We're going to touch on him a bit later inshallah ta'ala. He is from the children of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And he's not from the same mother as Hassan and Hussain. Because Hassan and Hussain, their mother was Fatima. And Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya was not from the side of Fatima. And this is important that we know this. Because later when the deviated sects come, and they disagree on after Hassan and Hussain, we will see inshallah ta'ala what caused it. Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu ta'ala, may Allah be pleased with him, Muhammad al-Hanafiyya, and his father, Ali ibn Abi Talib. He said that my father, أَتَى عَلِيٌّ دَارَ عُثْمَانٍ وَقَدْ قُتِلٍ. Muhammad al-Hanafiyya said that my father Ali came to the house of Uthman when he got killed. فَدَخَلَ إِلَىٰ دَارِهِ, Ali entered onto the building and the house of Uthman. وَأَغْلَقَ بَابَهُ عَلَيْهِ, and he closed the door on him. He entered and he closed the door on him. After he had visited him, spent time with him, and went and came back, Ali Uthman was dead. He got killed now. So Uthman, Ali ibn Abi Talib, he left the building of who? Of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. فَأَتَاهُ النَّاسُ, the people came to him. فَضَرَبُوا عَلَيْهِ الْبَابَ. So he's inside, Ali ibn Abi Talib is inside, the people knocked on the door to Ali ibn Abi Talib, and Uthman is dead in the house. The people entered. وَقَالُوا, they said to him, إِنَّ هَذَا الرَّجُلَ, this man, meaning referring to Uthman, قَدْ قُتِلْ, Uthman is killed. وَلَا بُدَّ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ خَلِيفَةٍ, and the people require a khalifa. وَلَا نَعْلَمُ أَحَدًا أَحَقَّ بِهَا مِنْكَ, and we do not see anybody more befitting to the khilafa than you. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, the people are saying, you're the one who should take over. فَقَالَ لَهُمْ عَلِيٌّ, Ali said, لا تريدني, you guys don't need me or don't want me, and you guys are not in need of me. فإني لكم وزير, I am a minister for you guys. خير لكم من أمير, خير لكم مني أمير, better for me than a leader. فقالوا, they said to him, لا والله, no, by Allah, لا نعلم أحد الأحق بها منك, we don't know anybody more befitting to this than you. We don't know. قال, he then said, فَإِنْ أَبَيْتُمْ, if you guys refuse and you still want to push this responsibility onto me, عَلَيَّ, فَإِنَّ بَيْعَتِي لَا تَكُونُ سِرًّا, then know one thing, my pledge of allegiance is not going to be private, behind closed doors. If you guys have pushed this responsibility onto me, then know, I won't do it just behind closed doors for five people. وَلَكِنْ أَخْرُجُ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ, rather, I will come out to the masjid. And I'll go to the masjid. فَمَنْ شَاءَ يُبَايِعَنِي بَايَعَنِي, anyone who wants to then give me pledge of allegiance, should then give me pledge of allegiance. فَخَرَجَ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ, Ali went to the masjid. فَبَايَعَهُ النَّاسُ, the people who gave him bayah. Imam Muhammad narrated this in his book, فَضَائِلُ الصَّحَابَ, وَإِسْنَادُهُ صَحِيحٌ, and the chain of narration is authentic. So Muhajirin and Ansar in Medina all gave him bayah. Some said there were some people who did not give him bayah, that withheld from giving him bay'ah. They said from those people were Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas, Abdullah ibn Umar, Muhammad ibn Maslama, and other than them did not give Ali ibn Abi Talib bay'ah. But another view points out that everyone gave him bay'ah. إِنَّهُ بُوِيَعَ مِنَ الْجَمِيعِ, every one of them gave bay'ah to Ali ibn Abi Talib. وَهَذَا هُوَ الْمَشْهُورِ, and that is the strongest view, that Abdullah ibn Umar, Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas, and Muhammad ibn Maslama, all of them gave bay'ah to Ali. All of them did. Rather, the reason of why that confusion came is because Sa'd ibn Abi Waqas, and Abdullah ibn Umar, and Muhammad ibn Maslama, they didn't hold back from the bay'ah. What they withheld back from was the battle that took place. They did not participate in that fighting. As for the bay'ah, they gave. So it wasn't the bay'ah they withheld back from, or they didn't do. What they didn't do was, they did not participate in the battles that took place between Mu'awiyah and Ali. They didn't. And they used to see it as a battle of fitna. Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the people of the Sunnah, are unanimously in agreement, ala anna afdalu sahabati ba'da Uthman, that the most virtuous companion after Uthman is Ali ibn Abi Talib. They are unanimously in agreement in that. That Ali was the Ali ibn Abi Talib was the after Uthman, the most virtuous one that he was. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, 4th volume, page 438. He says, Al-Mansus inda Ahmad ibn Hanbalin, what is textually transmitted from Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal is Tabdi'u man tawakkafa fi khilafati Ali. That person is an innovator. Innovator. The person who withholds from the authenticity or whether it was correct, the Khilafah of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Anyone who says, I don't know about the legitimacy of the Khilafah of Ali, I don't know, I'm going to withhold, Allahu Alam. Anyone who does that, Imam Muhammad saw him as a mubtadi'. And Imam Muhammad said, huwa adallu min himari ahlihi, and he's more misguided than the donkey. The Himar Ahli, he's more misguided than it. وَأَمَرَ بِهُجْرَانِهِ, and Imam Ahmad ordered that person to be boycotted. Anyone who says what? That Ali ibn Abi Talib's leadership, I don't know whether it was legitimate or not. Also, Imam Ahmad narrated in his book, Fada'il al-Sahaba bi-Isnadin Sahih, that Awf ibn Abi Jamilata, he said, كنت عند الحسن البصري. I was with Hassan al-Basri. وكان في المدينة عند مقتل عثمان. And Hassan al-Basri was present in the city of Medina when Uthman was killed. He was present. فذكروا أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. They mentioned to him, Hassan al-Basri, the companions of the Prophet. فقال ابن جوشن, the man ابن جوشن الغطفاني said, يا أبا سعيد, that was the kunya of Hassan al-Basri. He said, يا أبا سعيد, إنما زرني بأبي موسى أتباعه عليا. And what he means by that is, the people have started to slander in Abi Musa al-Ash'ari because he followed Ali ibn Abi Talib. People are criticizing and slandering Abi Musa al-Ash'ari because he saw the legitimacy of the Khilafah of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And it was that he didn't follow it. Hassan al-Basri then said, فغضب الحسن. Hassan got angry. حتى تبين في وجهي, until it became clear on his face. And then he said, فمن يتبع, who is the one who is followed? قتل أمير المؤمنين مظلوما. The أمير المؤمنين عثمان was killed by oppression and wrong. He was killed incorrectly and wrong. فعمد الناس إلى خيرهم. And the people then went towards the best man after عثمان. فبايعوه. They gave him بيعة. فمن يتبع. Who else did they have to follow? حتى رددها مرارا. Until Hassan al-Basri kept saying, فمن يتبع, فمن يتبع, فمن يتبع. Who is the one who is followed? Meaning after Uthman, who else was best than Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله تعالى عنه. So as I said, brothers and sisters, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah are unanimously in agreement that that the companions, the most virtuous person after the Prophet is Abu Bakr, then it's Umar. Then they disputed within Ahlul Sunnah, there is dispute. Who's more virtuous? Virtuous. We're talking about Fadl. Who's more virtuous, Uthman or Ali? Some have taken the view that Uthman is more virtuous, which is the view of the Jumhur of Ahlul Sunnah. And within Ahlul Sunnah, there are those who see Ali more virtuous than Uthman, but no one is allowed to see that Uthman's Khilafah was illegitimate because Ali was more virtuous than him. That's incorrect. That's a bid'ah and a mubtadi' and he's not from Ahlul Sunnah. There's a difference between the virtue and the Khilafah. The virtue, there's disputes regarding who, lakin, Uthman and Ali. Uthman and who? Ali. As for the Khilafah, the issue is innovation. Anyone who goes against Ahlul Sunnah, because the ijma' of the Sahabas was mun'aqid. The Sahabas' unanimous agreement on Uthman, and they also agreed upon Ali ibn Abi Talib to be the best person after who? After Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Brothers and sisters, أهم الأحداث في خلافة علي رضي الله تعالى عنه. We're now going to swiftly move on to the most important situation that took place, incidents that occurred through the Khilafah of Ali ibn Abi Talib. As you're all aware of, Ali ibn Abi Talib's Khilafah, the futuhat, the conquest, the opening of countries was really not that much in comparison to Umar and Uthman. The reason being many factors, but due to time and shortness of the time, we won't mention much of that inshallah ta'ala. We will focus on the more other important things that concern us for this series inshallah ta'ala. Ma'rakatul Jamal is the one I want to focus on inshallah ta'ala. When Ali ibn Abi Talib was given the bay'ah, and Ali was given pledge of allegiance, and the people in the masjid all came to him in numbers and they gave him bay'ah, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam, they both took permission from who? They both took permission and they were from those who gave bay'ah to Ali. It's not as it said. Talha and Zubayr, both of them gave bay'ah to Ali. And they took permission from their leader if they could go to Mecca. If they can go to Mecca, they took permission. And Ali permitted it for them. He let them go. When they went to Mecca, فَالْتَقَيَا هُنَاكَ بِأُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَائِشَةً. They went to Mecca and they met our mother, رضي الله تعالى عنها, may Allah be pleased with her. And may Allah be pleased with her father, Abu Bakr. They met her in Mecca, Aisha. وَقَدْ Aisha and the people of Mecca, it reached them that Uthman was killed. It reached them, they heard what had happened to Uthman. Aisha was in Mecca. And the people of Mecca heard of what took place in Medina and the killing of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Talhat and Zubair, all of them, they spoke about what took place to Uthman and how things were done to him. So they made the decision amongst themselves to take back Al-Akhdi Bitha'ri Uthman, to take revenge for those who killed Uthman. Ya'la ibn Munayyah, who came from Basra, Abdullah ibn Amir, who came from Kufa, all of them, they came in Mecca. Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Zubayr ibn Awam, and Aisha, all of them were in Mecca. They're sitting together. So we have Talha ibn Ubaidillah, who came from Mecca, Medina. Zubayr ibn Awam, who came from Medina. Aisha was already in Mecca. We also have Ya'la ibn Munayyah, who came from Basra. Abdullah ibn Amir, who came from Kufa. And they all came together to talk about this issue of the killing of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu. فَخَرَجُوا مِنْ مَكَّةِ. All of them left from Mecca. With those who agreed with them on this issue, in a number from Mecca. So those who I mentioned and those who agreed with the idea of getting back the revenge of Uthman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they all left and they directed themselves towards Basra. They went to Basra. Because in Basra, they were the ones who killed Uthman were in Basra. قَتَلَتْ Uthman, they were in Basra. And their intent and their aim and objective from that journey from Mecca to Basra was to only gain back the revenge of those who killed Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. Ali, on the other hand, he's in Medina. Ali had a governor elected for him for Basra. Basra had a governor that was a governor for Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu by the name of Uthman ibn Hunayf radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he was a waliyan ala al-Basra. He was a governor min qibali Ali ibn Abi Talib, from the angle of Ali. Ali elected him and pointed him there. فَلَمَّا وَصَلُوا إِلَى الْبَصْرَةِ. When they came to Basra, أُمِّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ عَائِشَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا وَزُبَيْرِ بْنَ عَوَّامٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ وَطَلْحَةِ بْنُ عُبَيْدِ اللَّهِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ and the rest, when they all came to what? To Basra. Uthman ibn Hunayf رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ heard. He heard what? He had heard that Aisha, the mother of the believers, and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam, all of them are where? They are at the gates of Basra. So he wrote to them. He wrote a letter to them and he asked them, ماذا تريدون? What do you guys want? قالوا, they said, نريد قتلة عثمان. What we want is those who killed Uthman رضي الله تعالى عنه. What has brought us out is that. فقال لهم, Uthman ibn Hunayf said to them, يأتي علي. Ali will come. He said to them, حتى يأتي علي. Until Ali ibn Abi Talib comes, I won't let you guys in. ومنعهم من الدخول. He didn't let Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنه in. He didn't let طلحة بن عبيدين and Zubayr ibn Awam. He didn't let them all three in. Until Ali ibn Abi Talib comes, and when Ali ibn Abi Talib comes, he will talk to you guys. And because Uthman ibn Hunayf refused to let the people of who? He refused to let Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam. What had happened was the people of Basra, they started to come into the ranks of who? Aisha and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam. They started to come into the ranks of them. Then when that happened, a battle took place between Uthman ibn Hunayfin and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Aisha. But a very small one. Nothing very big took place. When that battle that took place had happened, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he realized he had to go fast from Medina and he had to go to ila al-Kufa. And this is because he heard what? Uthman ibn Hunayf, he's governor in Basra, and Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam, and those who were with them, what took place? He realized that this is not a very light matter. And Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, being the mother of the believers, she could take a lot of people's hearts. Because this is the wife of who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam, people who've been promised Jannah alive. Na'am. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, he prepared an army very strong. And his army were 10,000. 10,000 individuals, and he brought them with the intention to fight Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam. 10,000 army, Ali got ready and he directed to fight. And here it becomes very clear. Ali ibn Abi Talib was the one who came out. And they didn't come out against them. Like Ali, Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam did not take their hands back from Ali as the Khilafah lil Mu'mineen, Khalifa of the Mu'mineen. Talha did not, and Zubayr ibn Awam did not, whatsoever. Lakin Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, may Allah elevate his status, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he prepared an army of 10,000 men to fight Talha and Zubayr. So they went to what? Ali ibn Abi Talib directed himself towards where? Ali ibn Abi Talib directed himself towards Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam. And Talha ibn Ubaidillah and Zubayr ibn Awam did not want to fight Ali ibn Abi Talib. And they didn't even intend to do khuruj, an uprise against Ali ibn Abi Talib. Naam.